someone who seems a little bit crazy would be Louis van Gaal. And you know him, Marizo. What works better for a player, having someone who's completely out there and a bit mad in Louis van Gaal in many ways, as opposed to a Brendan Rodgers character?
No, okay. When it comes to Louis van Gaal, I think, you know what the power is of Louis van Gaal? Is working with young kids. And I think when it comes to all the professionals, they cannot deal with certain attributes that he wants them to do. And sometimes that could be a tricky thing, because if you're like a more seasoned player and you're like, let's say 27, you won trophies, you know what's going on in the game, then a coach is going to come and tell you to do certain attributes. Some players don't take it well. And that is, I think, sometimes what you had the situation with Van Gaal. But when it comes to a young boy like myself, when I broke through, I tell you, I needed him. How many coaches, if I call a couple of things that took me after my Champions League game, I came home like, let's say we get to the stadium at 12 or 1 o'clock in the morning, and I had to call a friend to pick me up because I had no driver's license at that time. No, Van Gaal said, don't worry about that. I drive you home. He drove me home like almost like 5 or 6 Champions League games in the season. Then he had another thing. I got my driver's license. He said, how did you get to the training ground? I said, with the bus. He said, don't go with a public bus. Go and get your car. We're being sponsored. I called him up and make sure you get the car. So these are just a few things. And he took me from school. He called my school to take me, called my teacher to find out how I was doing at school, and then took me off and put me on an evening school because he said, you're struggling with the time because we had to train in the morning with the first team and you're first team player now. So that, those are the things. You see, I was a young boy. I needed someone like that, someone that looked over me. But when you're an older player, you don't need all that. And I think that is where the head bump comes. Because if you don't understand those players in the sense of like they don't want to be always being touched and set what to do. And I think that's what the crucial thing is with Van Gaal, and young and older. But away from that, Brendan, it seems like you understand both journeys. You understand how to handle a Vardy, but you also understand how to handle a Tielemans, for example, or a Madison. And I think that it comes down to coaching of these days now.
That is amazing. I didn't know he was driving you after matches home. And wow. Did you ever do that, Neil? Did you ever have to drive players home?
Yeah, sometimes it takes some of the younger players, you know, if they're waiting on a taxi or something like that, I'll go, get in with me, let's have a chat in the car and I'll take you home. So, you know, I think that's important. And we've all been young players, Mario. You know, we've all had our own experience in life, like, you know, and then sometimes that can work in your favour, you know, to get the respect of a young player, because they're evolving all the time, younger players. And, you know, I think looking at Brendan today, you know, you have no hesitation putting the young lad Thomas in, 19 years of age, you know, plays left wing back and wins a cup medal. He has great faith. He has great faith in Kieran Tierney. He's now at Arsenal. He's a wonderful player, really developed brilliantly under Brendan. Yeah. So, I mean, yeah, he's an all-rounder, Brendan, in terms of his coaching style and his man management as well.
If you put me in a car with the manager, I'll be silent as a mouse as a young kid. I'll be so nervous. I don't know how much the kids are talking to, Neil.
Wouldn't have wanted to get in a car with Martin O'Neill if we'd have got beaten at him.
Ah, yes. That would be a different story, I think. That would be an entirely different story. I can imagine.